The GenerateBlocks 2.0 release has really changed the way some of the things inside the editor work. One thing that I've seen people comment about struggling with is the way to achieve hover effects. Now, if you're not super familiar with the way CSS works, these changes might not be completely obvious, but once you have your mind wrapped around it, you'll see just how much more powerful the new system is compared to the old system. So in today's video, I thought we'd walk through a few different common hover effects and show you how to set these up using the new selectors panel inside GenerateBlocks 2.0 and above. If that sounds interesting to you, then stick around and let's get started. So I think we'll start off with a pretty simple example here. All I've put in so far is just my section and my inner container, or what I call a wrapper in here, and I'm just gonna add a container inside of it. Now we're just gonna need this to be a little bit bigger so we can see what's going on. So I'm gonna go ahead and give this a minimum height of 400 pixels. Now we can see our container's taking up a good amount of space. So let's just say we wanna give this a background color, and then when we hover on top of it, we wanna change that background color. So here with this container selected, I'm gonna go into backgrounds and I'm gonna change this background color to something in my palette like this lime green color. Now in old versions of GenerateBlocks, some of these colors would have a color swatch next to it for hover, but inside GenerateBlocks 2.0 and above, you need to use the selector panel in order to target the hover states. So if we go into our drop-down menu here in the selector for more, we can see some selectors already kind of built out for us as a helper. Now in here we have hover, and we also have hover and focus. In this case, I think hover is gonna be fine because this isn't a focusable element anyways, but a lot of times you actually do wanna use hover and focus, especially if what you're targeting is some kind of link. That way, if somebody's keyboard navigating through your website, this effect happens when they tab onto the element. But like I said, here we're just doing a background color, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use the hover selector. Now you can see my selector changed up here. This is the default one GenerateBlocks gave us for this element, so just kind of a random string of numbers here. But at the end, you'll see it has a colon and then the word hover. So this means now any changes we make to this style panel will only affect this container when it's being hovered. So like I said, I want to change the background color here, so I'm going to go into my background color and change this to my black color. Now, because we're only styling what happens on hover, we didn't see anything change on the page because we're not hovering this element right now. But if I take my mouse and hover over the element, you can see it changes that background to black. Now, because we didn't set any kind of transition, this is happening instantly, and I think it would probably look better if we had some kind of smooth transition between the two. So we need to set up a transition effect. Now we don't want to do this on the hover state, we want to do it just on the container itself. So to do that, I'm going to click this main button here, which will just take me back to the main selector. Now under the effects panel, I can go down and find transition. We'll go ahead and add a new transition. By default, it's set to half a second. Let's speed that up by doing maybe 0.35, and I'm going to change the timing function to ease in out. Now, when I hover over this container, you can see it smoothly transitions from that green background to the black background once I'm hovered on top. Now, a more practical example of where you might want to use something like this is here when you have some kind of card that's a link. When people hover over it, maybe you want some kind of box shadow, or maybe you want the card to slightly move up. We can do all of that using the same principles we just learned on the last example. So here you can see I've added a card. Inside that is a card image and then all of my card content. So I think the first thing I want to do is add a box shadow anytime we hover on top of this card. Now, because this card is a link, I also want to target that focus state as well. So I'm going to go down to my more dropdown, and I'm going to make sure that I select hover and focus. This way it will happen anytime I hover over the box or if I keyboard navigate and get focus on the box. So what I'm going to do is scroll down here until we get to our effects panel. I'm going to go to box shadow. And I'll go ahead and just start with this default one. You can see when I hover over it now, I'm getting that shadow. Now I'm gonna slightly change this, maybe zero offset. We'll make the blur pretty big, and I'm gonna change this spread to zero. Now when I hover over it, we have a subtle box shadow. It might be kind of hard to see on the screen here. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring that transparency up just to make it a little bit easier to see on this demo. Now whenever we hover over this box, we get this nice box shadow. Now it's a little jumpy and I want to make sure that this has a smooth transition. So just like before, I'm going to go back to our main selector here and we'll go down to our effects panel and we're going to go ahead and give this a transition. Maybe we'll do 0.25 seconds again and we'll do ease in out. And now when I hover over it, you can see that animation is nice and subtle. We go from not having a box shadow at all to when we hover over the element, we get this nice box shadow effect. But we can stack multiple effects on this card as well. Let's say we wanted it to move up slightly whenever we hover on top of it. So we'll just go back up here to our selectors, into our more dropdown, and into hover and focus. And we'll just collapse these panels here so we can get right to our effects panel. And here we already have the box shadow effect, but what I want to do is add a second effect here for our transform. So I'm going to go ahead and click on transform. It defaults to translate, which is exactly what we want. And what we want to do in this case is move this box up by maybe 5 pixels. So to do that, we're going to go on the translate Y and we're going to do -5px for pixels. Now, when we hover over this, you can see it's moving slightly up as we hover over it. Just to exaggerate that, I'll change it to maybe 10 pixels. And you can see it moves 10 pixels up anytime we hover over it. Now, because on our main selector here under our transition, we did this as transition all, it's going ahead and applying that same transition to each one of these effects. However, if you wanted to have a different transition on the box shadow and the translate of this, you could accomplish that here inside GenerateBlocks. What we'd want to do is if we want to preserve that 0.25 ease in out for our box shadow, we can change this transition property to box shadow. You'll just need to type that in the box here. And you can see now it's immediately jumping up and the box shadow is actually transitioning smoothly. Of course, we're going to want to add a transition to that translate as well. So what we'll do is just click on add new transition here. And maybe we do a really slow move. So we'll change this to 1 second. And we'll change this transition property to transform. And now we'll go ahead and hit our check mark. And we can see the box shadow should happen in 0.25 seconds, but that transform should take a full second to complete. So now when we hover over the box, we should see the box shadow relatively quickly, but the transform is going to take a full second to complete its move to 10 pixels higher. So we can see the box shadow came in really quickly, but the transform happened over a full second. We could definitely exaggerate that if we wanted to and maybe make this 5 seconds. We'll go ahead and save that. And now we can see the box shadow comes in and the card is slowly moving up those 10 pixels. It's going to take a full 5 seconds for that to happen. Now by default, the transition property is going to be set to all when you add a new transition. But if you just want to transition a specific property, you can always type it directly into this box. Now this is a cool effect on its own, but what's really nice is when you can affect an element inside your card when you hover on the card itself. So let me show you an example of how you could set that up using the same system. So what we're going to try to accomplish now is changing the color of this headline whenever we hover anywhere on top of this card. So to do that, the first thing I need to do is take note of whatever class this headline has. Now I'm just using the default classes that GenerateBlocks gives us. In production, you're probably going to want to give all of these their own unique class, but for now we're just going to use the default classes. I'm going to go ahead and highlight this class and copy it to my clipboard because we're going to need that here in a second. I'll go back here and select my card, and now we're going to need to create our own custom selector. Essentially, what we want to do is select the headline only when the card is either hovered or focused. So to do that, we're going to click this More dropdown, and we're going to click the New button here to create our own selector. In this case, we do want to use a compound selector, and here I want to use the same format that GenerateBlocks uses for the hover or focus. To do that, we type in colon is, we open our parentheses and type in colon focus, comma, colon hover. And now we can close our parentheses. Now after that, because I'm actually wanting to select the headline within it, I'm going to type in a space here, and then I'm going to paste in that selector for our headline that we copied to our clipboard. So if I go ahead and hit create now, we can take a look at our selector. What we have is this card element here when it is hovered or focused, and then we're selecting the headline within it. So we'll go in here and we'll just change this color. I'm just going to give us a bright red color here. And now whenever we hover or focus on this card, it should change the headline to red. So here you can see the headline changed to red as soon as we hovered or focused on this card. Of course, we're not getting that smooth transition that we have for our box shadow and for our transform that is taking ages now to complete. Because the thing that's changing in this is that headline itself, we actually need to add a transition to the headline. So I'm going to go ahead and select our headline here. We just want this default class, not the hover or focus state. And we'll go down to our effects panel here, and we'll go under transition. Maybe we'll do this similar to the box shadow, which was 0.25 seconds, ease in, out. Now when we hover over a box, we have a nice smooth transition of that headline that goes from the default black color to the red color, which is just another visual indicator that we're hovering over this box. Now I went kind of fast through that, so let's do it again for the text underneath it. We'll change it to red as well. Not a very practical example, but just to get some practice doing this. I'm going to go ahead and select the class here for our description. We'll go back into our card, and we'll go ahead and build out that selector again. We'll click the More dropdown, we'll click New. We're going to turn on our compound selector and type in is, hover, focus, a space, and then we'll paste in that selector for our description and hit Create. Now we'll go down into our typography and we'll change this to red. Now we can see when we hover over our card, it does change that text to red immediately, which is great. But we need to go back to our description text here and add that same transition. So we'll go into Effects, Transition, 0.25 seconds, ease in, out. And now the headline and the description text underneath it should both change to red at the same pace. If you're used to writing a lot of CSS by hand, then all of this should seem really familiar. The way GenerateBlocks works now is basically everything maps one-to-one to the CSS property itself. This gives us a whole lot of control that we didn't have before when we were really just limited to the options GenerateBlocks gave us. Now we have full control over the CSS and can write anything we want. I would really encourage you to keep learning more and more about CSS because it's going to unlock your potential and give you the ability to create things that just weren't possible inside the old editor. If this was helpful, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up, and if you want to make sure to catch the next one, hit subscribe and we'll see you then.